we had a look at how RouterOS arrays can be defined as a list of values or as a list of value and key pairs. Now we'll further explore how we can work with this data type. Here I have two kinds of arrays that I mentioned, and even though they might seem fundamentally different, in RouterOS they are compatible. I can create a third array by concatenating the first two if I want to. This can be done with a simple comma. And then if I print the output, we will see that the order has changed. The values without a key were simply placed at the start of the array, but the keyed values get moved to the end and reordered alphabetically. Those are a couple of nuances that you have to keep in mind when concatenating arrays. Simple keyless arrays will not get reordered. They will just get combined as you would expect with regular arrays. But whenever you add entries with keys into the mixture, those keyed entries will get moved to the end and sorted alphabetically. Now, to retrieve a specific value from an array, we could of course use an index similar to regular arrays. The syntax is to put the array call in brackets and create this little arrow pointing at our index using a dash and the greater than symbol. So I have successfully called the very first element with index 0. However, the index will only work with elements that do not have a key. So if I want to call one of the last three elements in this array, I have to use the key in place of the index, and I'll be able to get those values. Personally, I wouldn't use combined arrays like this just out of principle, because I don't want to confuse myself. For example, if I create another script with two elements, index 0 is going to be the letter A, but then the next element is going to have a key 0 and value B. Now, what do you think will happen when I try to call it? Which element is going to be returned? Well, the answer is that the number 0 is calling the index. And if I create another call with 0 in quotes, that 0 is a string and will be calling a key. If I run this, you can see that both calls got executed and returned the elements correctly. So you can do it this way if you want. I wouldn't recommend it. Just try to keep your regular arrays separate from the dictionary type. All right, there could be different situations where you can make use of arrays. But if you're going to make anything complex, you will have to parse RouterOS outputs, and there is a built-in way to receive those outputs as arrays. If you try to retrieve the output of a print command through a regular command substitution, then what will happen is this. The script will simply run the print command as if it was typed into the terminal, and then you can see the very last line is the result of the type of command. It is nil, because no value was passed to the variable. Now let's make a little change to the script and add the asValue parameter to the print command. When I run this, there is no visible output, and our variable is now properly defined as an array. Next, we could iterate over the array using foreach loop. The syntax is pretty simple. First, we define two variables that will represent key and value. If you only defined a single variable here, you would be working with values only. Next, type in equals the array that you are working with. After that, do a section with the commands that should be executed in each loop. This script now returns something similar to the regular print command. There is also a more specific command in get. In sections like the system resource, where the output is an array with key value pairs, it works identically to the print as value. But we can also specify which value we would like to return. If we wanted to work with uptime, this would have saved us some hassle with parsing. However, not all sections will be like this. Whenever there is a list of entries, like interfaces or addresses, the output of print as value is going to be an array of arrays. And similarly, the get command will not be able to return anything unless you specify which array you would like to get. For example, with interface get, now I also have to identify the array. I can use the interface name, but remember, ID is preferable. The output is now a whole array, but get can take another parameter. So I could query for the running status, for example. If you do want to read and process all of the information of, or most of it, then you will be better to run a loop inside a loop. Here's an example. The first loop iterates over the master array of all interfaces. Then, second loop goes over the individual interface arrays and neatly prints the contents. Of course, this is where you would place all the other actions that you would perform with that information. And this is what the output would look like in case you are wondering. You could use a script to display a neat table of information that is relevant to you, but more likely you might want to automate something. For example, you could check when an interface is running or a certain device is detected through neighbor discovery or Wi-Fi access list and enable a rate limit or just send yourself a notification. The last thing I should mention on arrays is the toarray command. If for whatever reason you have a string with numbers or characters separated by commas and you need to turn it into an array, just run this command and the output will be an array.